to look good in Paris. But we so happy to be in Fairfax, Virginia. It took us a mighty long time to get here. We started out at 10 o'clock last night. And I want to say we got to Brother Vincent's house. It was about 12:15. We slept a little while. We drove a whole lot. And we thank God for traveling grace.
Thank you.
42 children. Yeah. They said, your papa was a rolling stone. I said, he rolled my little stones fast. But my sisters would be getting ready to go to the nightclubs. They would be picking out them big old afros. Getting ready to go have a good time. And they would put on a song. My house, so when I got older, I heard that song. through fasting and praying.
That's right.
And how many of you know some things come through waiting?
Well,
waiting on the Lord.
Yeah, that's right.
Waiting don't mean just being still.
Yeah.
When you go to the restaurant and they wait on you, don't they serve you?
Oh,
brought me from, because it's going to bless somebody. Back in 2013, got connected to the wrong man. Lost my job, was down on my luck. And was afraid of losing everything, because people always knew, you know, Steph did pretty well, so I didn't want to give folks nothing to talk about. Not understanding that my shame is always God's glory. That's what the word of God said. Got connected with the wrong person. Before I knew it, he was one of the highest ranked gang members, pushing drugs. And I remember wanting to walk away, but couldn't walk away. Praise your name. Bless your name. And I started picking up, taking money. All the way, all up through here. It's so amazing when I come through here now and you can say, thank God, when I travel through here now, about God's business and not my own. One day God spoke to me. Three different people, two sisters and one mother, said God spoke to me. My sister called and said, I see drug dogs in your house. God told me to tell you, you better get away from that man and you better quit what you do. My sister in Atlanta was sitting down having lunch with her one day. And she looked me in my face and said, you ain't up here selling dope, are you? And I hung my head down in shame. And one Wednesday, specifically on a Wednesday, I was in the mirror trying to draw these eyebrows, and God know how to do it. And God spoke to me and said, you better get away from that man. And you better quit pushing that dope. He said, I allow you to do what you're doing. He said, but I'm gonna pull the cover off of you. And when I do, it's gonna hurt some people, because some people really believe singing on a Saturday night and a Sunday, but wasn't living nothing all week long. He told me he was gonna bring me to an open chair. And when I didn't move, what God said, one day the man, I told the man, I said, I can't do it no more. God said, I gotta stop. He said, well, I guess you're gonna tell God to pay your bills. I said, I sure am gonna tell him to pay my bills. See, a lot of times we trust God for one thing, but we don't trust him for everything. Well, he told me, he said, I'm gonna make a run and I'll be back. When he left, something told me, go look in the closet. When I looked in the closet, he had took everything, all the money was gone, and never came back. I want you to know that God allowed me. I was homeless for 11 months. I lost everything I had, Car, vehicles, everything, everything was sitting outside. People were going through my things. I lost everything. And for 11 months, God allowed me to be homeless. But while we're down, this is what I've learned. While I'm on my knees, I'm going to go on and worship you since I'm all over the world. While I'm on my knees, I'm just going to worship you. I don't have a house on the hill. But when I tell you, when God blessed me with a home, baby, I appreciate it now. You know those things that we used to take for granted. And he saw me, and I had my sister laugh, and I said, I guess the people thought I had started drinking because they saw me going to the liquor store. But I was going to the liquor store to pay my deposit, and I go in there every month and pay my rent. Sometimes I say, Lord, I wonder who they think I'm going to get me some of that 2020 bag dollar.
Yeah.
And not only did he give me a song, anybody know he'll bless you even in your mess, he'll bless you. People say, no, I don't guess he will. Look behind, he got to reach way down. Anybody know he will pick you up? That's just folks saying that because they don't want to see you blessed. They look at you and wonder how in the world she did it. All she did. But God gave me a song and gave me a promise. And it said that if you live right,
Amen.